Do you feel like you're not fully in control when generating AI images? Now there's a new way to get exactly the results you want. Hey, this is Mia. Today's sponsor, CGDream, is a powerful AI image generation platform. It offers a unique 3D to image solution that allows you to generate images based on 3D models. With this feature, you can adjust the angle and direction of your characters or objects for an image generation, which gives you unprecedented control to tell your story. CGDream also offers some of the highest quality results with its various powerful features that make personalizing your images effortless. Plus, you can generate tons of images for free each month. You won't want to miss what CGDream can do. Let me show you how it works. There are many ways you can generate images with CGDream, like text to image, image to image, and 3D to image. First, let's take a look at their text to image. All you have to do is to go to the bottom prompt box and input your text prompt here to generate the image. Let's try cat in boots. I want to keep the prompt super short so you know how easy it is to prompt on CGDream. We can see how much each generation costs before clicking the generate button. Let's click generate. You can find your image generations under my images. I think this is already a pretty high quality result without any filters or fancy prompts to guide the image. But there's of course a lot more you can do to make it more customized. At the bottom, you'll find the filter button. We can select filters here, and they have more than 200 LoRa filters we can apply and mix and match to stylize and enhance the image results. And also, CGDream actually goes an extra mile to suggest related filters to use at the top based on your text prompts. So it may save you time to find the right filters. You'll find the filters suggested here are pretty fitting for my cat in boots prompt. So let's pick these ones. And we can also search the filter by keywords. If you want to see how the filter is like on other images, just click the magnifying glass icon to see more of the images with that filter. So you can get a feel of what the filter do. And we can select up to 5 filters for each generation. On the left, we will find our selected filters. And here we can adjust how much influence each filter has on the image. Let's see. So after you set up the filter strength, moving to the right panel, we can further adjust the setting of the generation. Here we can pick the image aspect ratio. And here we can pick how many image variation we can generate at a time. And it is limited based on the plan you're in. And if we're using the default Juggernaut XL, we can adjust the prompt guidance to control the creativity of the AI. So lower values will give you a more chaotic and creative image, while higher values will make it more defined and contrasting. CGDream also offers two image models, Juggernaut XL, which is based on Stable Diffusion XL, and the popular Flux model. I personally prefer Flux because I think it often produces higher quality results and stick more closely to my prompt. And here you can also choose the speed and quality of the generation if you're on the Juggernaut XL. So the auto-enhanced short prompt is a unique feature. If you enable this one and your prompt is 3 words or fewer, it will automatically enhance the prompt using its dream up feature. For C, you can generally keep it at random unless you want more consistent output and less randomness of your images. For Juggernaut XL model, you would have the choice of inputting negative prompt. You can put things that you don't want to see in the image, giving you more control of your result. Also, by the way, if you're on the pay plan, you can toggle the private mode on the right to keep your generations private. And to generate our result, you'll notice there are 2 buttons you can click for the next step. If you simply click generate, it will use your written prompt directly along with your other settings to produce the image. But if you click the dream up button, the AI will take your existing prompt and enhance it by adding more details, taking your selected filters into consideration. If you don't have a prompt in place, the AI will generate a random image for you. This feature is helpful when you don't have specific ideas about your image generation or want to explore different possibilities, which is most of the case for me. Let's try the dream up button and see what it comes up with. We can find our image results in my images. This is so cute. You can see the depth of field and details like the cat fur as well as the incorporation of filters we selected into this image. If we click on the image, it will load the filters, text prompt, and settings on the panel for us to regenerate. On the text prompt, you can see that the Dream Up feature has expanded the prompt I put in into these detail-rich instructions that also incorporate the descriptions from the filters. I really like this unique process of generating images, where I can retain control by selecting the filter, but at the same time, I don't have to think about the specific language to use for text prompt, which I struggle sometimes. If we click this button, we can also creatively upscale the image by 2x directly on this platform. You can see that the upscale version has a lot more details and added texture, and it is much crisper when zooming in. The AI has reimagined some of the details of the image and add extra details that weren't there before. So on the left-hand side panel, you can upload a reference image to generate new images based on it. The style reference option allows you to reference only the style. The structure image lets you reference the structure and composition of the image, and the reference image option lets you reference the overall image in terms of both style and structure. So you can create something very similar to your uploaded image. And you can even use a 3D model as a reference, which we'll cover later. Let's upload a reference image. I want to create something similar to this little girl meditating in a wood image. You can adjust the strength setting to control how much the reference image affects the generated image. Setting the strength over 0.5 will produce results very close to your original image. So if you want some variation while still keeping similarity to what you uploaded, I recommend setting it to be between 0.3 and 0.5. So the change will be more noticeable. Next, let's add some filters and adjust their strengths. I'm hoping the cartoon fantasy filter will influence the outcome more, so we will give it more strength. Let's make the variation 3 and pick the Flux model. It keeps perfect style and structure of the original image, but it's a great improvement of what we originally have. We can see that the different elements from the filters are coming through the image. I think the little animals added are probably from the cartoon fantasy or mystical creature filter. We can also see some ivy and vine elements applied to the trees in the background. And I think the extra details added to her clothes is probably influenced by the fairy tale filter. We can achieve pretty creative outcomes by adjusting the strengths and the types of the filters you use with different prompts. In comparison, the generation without the Dream Up features stay pretty closely to the reference image. They're still pretty high quality, but just doesn't have the same extra details that the Dream Up feature add. Click this icon and we can edit part of the image using the ink paint feature that they have. Let's adjust the brush size and paint over the region we want to regenerate. In the text prompt, we'll input what we want to see here. I'll just type a bouquet of flowers and generate. We can also mix and match the reference images to generate interesting results. Let's use this one as the style reference and this ice cream truck image as the structure reference. The prompt is an ice cream truck parked by the beach, and then we use Dream Up to generate. And the result takes in the style and colorful color of our style reference image, and it plays the ice cream truck in the exact angle and look of my reference image. And this is the most exciting feature of CGDream. You can upload or choose a 3D model from their gallery, enter your prompt, and let the AI create a new 2D image based on the 3D model and your input. There are tons of 3D models in their 3D model library that we can choose from. Let's try this bridge. After you enter the 3D model mode, the default setting is orbit. When you click and hold your mouse and move it like this, you can rotate the object and view it from different angles. If you choose the walk mode, you can navigate as if you're in the first-person game. You can use either the arrow keys or the WASD keys on your keyboard like in a game. The walk option is especially useful when using an interior and environment 3D model, and toggle the ground on and off. We can also adjust the field of view like this. Additionally, we can choose between color render or tomb render. Use color renders if you want the generated image to have realistic textures, detailed environments, and lifelike characters. And you can choose the tomb render if you're aiming for a stylized graphic look with simplified details. I think this angle looks good. Let's select some filters. I'll just put a simple prompt and let the Dream Up feature to imagine the image for me. This is so cute. The angle of the bridge is exactly how I set it, and I really like the filter combinations here. I think this could be a great children's book style. Let me try other 3D models with the same mix of filters to see if we can create images that belong in the same story universe. These are so cute. I really like this way of prompting where it minimizes the need for text prompt but still give you plenty of control over your images. And if you can find the 3D models in their library, you can upload your own 3D models from somewhere else. Or you can visit their other platform, CGTrader, which offers millions of 3D models. Many of them are paid, but you can toggle the free button to find the free ones. Let's pick this one. Once you click download on a free model, you'll have to watch an ad of about 20 seconds. After it's done, you can pick the file type to download. And you'll want to download the FBX and GLB file to upload to CGDream. Let's generate the image from the angle we like best. We can also convert our own images into 3D models on CGDream. Let's try it with this girl image we generated earlier. Click on this button to convert the image into a 3D model. Once it's done, we can click again to enter the 3D model mode. Sometimes the 3D model isn't quite defined and it's a bit blurry. But don't worry, that's perfectly fine since the AI only takes in the rough structure. We can still generate very high quality results. Let's focus the camera from this angle. In my experience, we need to increase the influence of the 3D model to about over 0.7 to sufficiently impact the outcome for this one. And then we'll put in a rough prompt and set up the filters. Let's generate this with Dream Up. It generated the same posture of the girl with the exact angle without me actually specifying any details. It's probably not easy to get this exact angle right if you don't have a 3D model prompting tool like this. I love how the knitting filter is applied to her outfit. The gentle light coming from the right and the illumination from the crystal all adds a high quality cinematic feel to the image. If you want to use the same 3D model, you can click this icon in here to get back to it and see the original prompt and settings you used to prompt the image. When it comes to pricing, CGDream offers a generous free tier where you get 100 credits per day. This means you can generate up to 770 SDXL images or 160 Flux images per month. And you also have access to the 3D model generation feature. If you need more, their pay plans start at just $8 per month, giving you 10,000 credits along with additional features like commercial usage rights and the ability to generate your images privately. To learn more, you can visit their pricing page to decide which plan best fits your needs. Overall, I really enjoyed this new way of prompting on CGDream, especially the 3D to image option. It offers a lot of potential for different kinds of applications. I hope you find the tool as interesting as I do. Give it a try using my link below and let me know what you think. Thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next one. Thank you CGDream for sponsoring this video.